Everybody?
Yes, I applaud.
Oh, yes, good. Please.
Very good, very good. You are going to work within a different company today. Understand the QuickBooks now, right? It's very easy.
Yes.
If you understand the screen, then it's easy to register everything. Today we are going to learn different company. Page 331. Anybody going to read about objectives, Bina?
Objectives?
Yeah, from objective, if you start from objective, it's good, okay. Because you will know, you are going to learn what kind of transcriptions. Yeah.
Okay. After completing this chapter, you should be able to apply sales discounts to receipts from customers and apply purchase discounts to payments, apply sales and purchase credits and deposits, prepare sales estimates for customers, enter sales orders for customers, customize, estimate, and order form for customers, enter purchase orders, enter payments from customers, enter prepayments to vendors, enter credit card sales, enter memorized transactions, enter bills for received items, enter sales invoices from orders and estimates, and fill purchase orders.
This time you are going to learn new transactions, discounts, purchase orders, credits, those kind of things. Do you want to continue about company information?
Company information?
Yeah.
Company profile. Terrific Tours in Calgary, Alberta is owned and operated by Icheris Manitola. His wife, Serena, is employed by the business. Serena was working as a flight attendant and Icheris was employed in a travel agency when they met. Several years later, Icheris started his own travel agency and his wife resigned from her job and is now employed by her husband. Planning trips for others did not fulfill their own desire to travel, so Icheris and Serena decided to add hosted tours to the business a few years ago. They took additional travel and hospitality courses offered by the community college to help them prepare for the tour business. The tour business has grown steadily and now employs their sons. Because of the Manitoba's personal interest in education and the arts, they organize all-inclusive guided tours for school groups and seniors with themes like art, architecture, or gardens. They arrange air, hotel, meals, local transportation, local guides, and admission to local attractions to feed the tourists then. Most tours occur throughout the school years, September to June, to avoid the peak prices and summer holiday crowds. During the summers, the Manitoba's plan the towers for the coming year. One family member accompanies each tower as a concierge and makes local arrangements such as paying the hotel, restaurant, and admission bills, arranging emergency medical care, and troubleshooting to help trips run smoothly. All student groups travel with adult chaperones. Them towers are also available to individual clients. Often well-educated professionals with flexible schedule that allow them to travel off-season. These customers may join in the full tour or buy only the air travel portion of the trip and make their own arrangements for hotel and local sightseeing. Prices vary with the tower length and location, and with the variety of planned events. A 5% discount for groups of more than 10 allows the group chaperones to travel for half price. Individual customers pay full price for all tours. Schools and groups who have accounts with Cherokee Towers receive an additional 1% discount if they settle their accounts within 10 days of the booking date. Deposits are requested at the time of booking because the airlines and hotels used by Cherokee Towers also require deposits. Individual customers usually pay by credit card, while account customers pay by check. Athabasca Alumni Association and an account customer has just confirmed a tour to Papua for the month of October and has paid the deposit. Terrific tours always give their clients travel accessories as a gift. Wrist or neck wallets or a small carry-on tote bag. The business places special orders for these promotional items that are printed with the company name and logo, and it keeps inventory of these items on hand. Terrific Towers has accounts with major airlines and hotel chains. Because of the volume of business, the company receives preferential prices from these vendors as well as discounts for early account settlement. Some vendors request prepayments or deposits from the tower company. Most accounts are paid by check, but some smaller purchases are paid by credit card. Credit cards are also used for incidental expenses incurred during the tours. Customers pay 5% GST on the airfare component of the tower package. The tower component is not taxable because it occurs outside of Canada. Terrific Towers pays GST on business-related purchases. Provincial sales taxes are not levied in Alberta. At the end of September 2012, 2 months into our new fiscal year, Terrific Towers converted their accounting reports to QuickBooks using the following
Now you understand what kind of company you are going to work with, what kind of activities you are going to do it, right? If you understand what kind of company, it's easier to do the journals. Go to page 337, and that is SD1, Memo 1, Applying Credit Customers Accounts. If you read that passage, then you will understand what kind of, what are you going to do. Do you want to read Applying Credit to Customer Accounts?
Applying Credits to Customers Accounts. Business frequently asks customers to pay a deposit when they make a purchase on account. Prepayments can serve several purposes. They allow the business to order and pay for items required for a job for that customer. They help to ensure that a customer will proceed with their purchase. They reduce the final amount owing by the customer so that the customer will not exceed the credit limit, and so on. The deposit creates a credit balance in the customer's receivable account. When a sales invoice is recorded, the initial credit balance reduces the amount owing from the invoice. Terrific Towers requires a deposit of about 50% of the total tower package price. When a customer confirms a tower, accepts a sales estimate, or places an order, after the money is received and an invoice is prepared, the deposit must be applied to the balance owing by the customer. The first transaction that we will enter is a deposit that needs to be applied to recorded sales invoices for Athabasca Alumni Association. The deposit has already been received. Refer to the following source documents as we work through the step to enter it.
We want to read memo one also.
Okay. Memo number one, dated October 1st, 2012. Apply the deposit to the balance owing from Athabasca Harmonies Association. Apply $8,000 to invoice number 208 and $18,000 to invoice number 210.
You understand what
I've said this. Let me tell you. Hello, Matilda, please let Udeka in.
Everybody's here, right? Okay. You know what you're going to do is, right? Athabasca Alumni Association, they paid advance earlier. That's a prepayment. That is in our account, that is unknown income, right? That credit you are going to apply for the invoices. If you want to see the advance, the prepayment, you have to go to receipt payment. Click on receipt payment. Everybody open computer, open QuickBooks, right?
Yeah.
Okay. And when you open the receipt payment, select the customer at the Athabasca Alumni, type A, then you can find out. And now you can see the credit balance in the bottom.
Mm-hmm.
Available credits, 26,000. Did you see that in the bottom?
Yes.
That is the prepayment they paid. Now you're going to apply for these two invoices. One invoice, 208 is 8,000, other one is 18,000. You're going to apply for this credit for these two invoices, 8,000 for one invoice, 18,000 for other invoice. You understand what they're going to do is, October 1st, and don't put any amount here. I'm going to apply for first invoice. Then highlight the first invoice. Don't put the tick mark. Just highlight. After you highlight, on the top, you can see discount and credits. On the top, there are icons. You can see discounts and credits.
Mm-hmm.
Click on discounts and credits. You're going to apply only credits now. Now you're going to apply 8,000 only for this one.
Change it?
Yeah, change it. Because system automatically take the money, but you are going to change according to 8,000. After you apply, Then there's a discount button here, the discount tab, because the system automatically calculate the discount also according to the date. Go to the discount. This time, this is the prepayment. You are not going to give discount for this. Take off the discount. Make zero for discount. And check the credit. You applied $8,000. Now, press done. Now we applied 8,000 for the first invoice. You can see here you already applied 8,000 for the first invoice. And now you have only 18,000, that one for the second invoice. Click on the second invoice. Don't put the tick mark. And again, go back to discount and credit. Everybody is following, right? The system automatically take the balance, 18,000. Check the discount. If the discount is counted, they take off the discount. And say done. Now you already applied all the discounts, all the credits. You can see here, you applied 8,000 for the first invoice, 18,000 for the second invoice. You understand now, right? Don't put the amount here. Pardon me?
Sorry, I have a question. So when you go to discount, right? So I see the discount is populated. Is it because of the payment terms or is it like always the case?
Because when we set up the customer, we set up about the discount also. The system, when you put the date, the system automatically calculate the discount. Because this is the prepayment, you are not going to charge, you are not going to give discount for the prepayment. That's what you are taking out.
So basically my question was like, why is there like a discount there? Is it because of the payment terms?
Yeah, payment terms.
Okay.
Yeah, because of the payment terms. Yeah. According to the payment terms, the system is recognizing to take the discount, but for prepayment, no discount. Now you can say save.
Matilda?
Yeah?
So on this screen, right, there's a discount date of October 1st, I mean October 4th and October 6th, right? Like on the screen, right?
Yeah, October 1st, right?
But it gives to us...
Yeah, so the date of the, we're applying the payment on October 1st, right?
Yeah.
But there is a discount date of October the 4th, right? So
yeah.
So why are we not giving them the discount?
Because this is a prepayment.
Okay.
The prepayment, no discount.
Okay.
Yeah. That's what you read in the company information. She already read about the confirmation in the company information. They say no discount for the prepayment.
Okay.
Yeah.
We're supposed to pay in 4 and 6 October, right?
Yeah.
But we paid in 1st October.
No, this one we didn't pay. This one is advance. We are applying.
Okay.
Actually, the company, they're always asking advance 50%. This is the tour company for the flight and everything. They are asking advance. That advance, it is in the system. Now the advance we are applying for the invoices. When you are applying advance is the prepayment, no discount for the prepayment.
Okay.
Are you okay?
Yes.
Yeah. Now you can save and close.
Matilda, may I ask you something?
Yeah.
Could you please go back to discounts and credits? Because I don't understand when I'm taking the amount and put zero on discount.
Mm-hmm.
Discount account, what I supposed, which account I supposed to choose?
Sales discount. You don't have to use. Take off zero because you are going to apply discount when you receive the money. This one is already received as a prepayment. That is your unearned income. You have it in your unearned income. You are applying that unearned income in the for the invoice. At that time, you don't have to apply discount. That's what you are deleting discount. But when you are applying discount, this discount account is sales discount. When you click on this, you can see sales
discount.
Yeah, sales discount.
But the amount of discount is supposed to be 385.20, right?
No, zero.
Zero.
Yeah, because of the prepayment, you are not giving discount. This is the prepayment they applied earlier. According to the company's information, rules and regulations, for prepayment, no discount.
Okay, Matilda, I'm like reading the book again on page 336.
Mm-hmm.
Says that some vendors offer discount for early payment, but nowhere does it say that you don't get a discount for early payment. I mean, for prepayment. Like, where is it in the book? Because on page 336, I don't see it. On page 335, I don't see it.
I think somewhere else I noticed that. But actually, no prepayment, no discount for the prepayment in the real life too, right?
Okay. Yeah, no, because I was just going by the example in the book, right?
Yeah.
It's 337.
It is.
I don't know. At the end, I have a different amount.
Yeah, because in the book, the only thing they mention is like discounts for early payment.
Yeah.
They don't get anything for prepayment. Okay.
Yeah, it's not anything for prepayment, but only for early payment. Early payment is not the prepayment, right?
I think the same. They are the same. I'm not sure.
Prepayment is, according to the company, they always ask advance for their purpose. Then when they pay advance, they're not discount for the advance.
So how do you differentiate between early payment and prepayment in the system?
No.
How do you differentiate? So for example, there's a credit of...
Okay, this is the credit you applied, right? This is the credit you applied. Credit is unearned income. You applied already. After that, there is some balance, right?
Yeah.
50% advance you receive from them, that's what you applied. When they are paying the balance, if they pay early, that one you are going to apply discount.
Okay, so my question is like, so we have 26,000 remaining, right? So how do I know that it's from the previous check? Like, is there a way I can see that it's from a previous check?
Yeah. When you take the money, you are applying for that company, the same. You are going to apply the prepayment, then you will understand.
Okay.
This is already applied. That's what now you are applying the credit. The other transaction, you are going to take prepayment for the customers. At the time, you will know how it comes for the customer's file. Are you okay, Mohammed?
Yeah, you know, I think I understand. Because like the only question I had was like, there's like a 26,000. So when we started with the 26,000, I wanted to know like how that credit came to be, right? Because you're saying there's like a residual from the previous check they sent in, right?
Yeah.
So they sent in a previous check?
They paid in September.
Okay.
When they are sending the sales order, they're asking for 50% advance. Before they decide, then they pay that. After they pay that funds, they are sending the invoice. Then invoice is in the book, advance also in the book. Now you are applying. Normally, when you are recording the invoice, the system always asks you whether you want to apply the credit or not. According to this, they didn't apply the credit. Credit is there, but now you are applying. Credit is in the liability account. Now you are applying.
Okay.
So
I understand.
Sorry. Continue to speak. I'll ask you later.
So basically, okay, like if the 26,000 is the early check, we would have recorded in a different way rather than credit. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. What is your question, Valentina?
I have a different amount. So I just cannot understand why I have a different amount, because I have the same invoice numbers, but the amounts. Or you have changed this amount of credits to 8,000.
Mm-hmm.
I cannot understand where
because is it. Because they are saying like 8,000 to invoice 208, 18,000 to invoice 210.
So this, I have to put the...
Yeah, because you have 28,000, when you open the credit, discount and credit, the system automatically takes the whole amount. But you have to change the 8,000 only for the first invoice. You have to leave 18,000 for the second invoice.
18 or 17?
18 for the second invoice. The first invoice, highlight the first invoice and go to discount and credit. In the credit, we already applied. That's what I couldn't see that. Oh, it's here. Yeah. See, I applied 8,000. When is he, instead of 17,000, change for 8,000. Okay. Valentina?
To be honest, I don't understand.
Okay, start from the beginning. Don't save it. Go to receive payment. When you go to receive payment, you can see 26,000 here in the bottom, right?
Yes.
That 26,000, you have to apply 8,000 for one invoice, 18,000 for the second invoice. Because they paid 50% of this invoice and 50% of this invoice. That one is 8,000 for this, 18,000 for this. Right? In the system, you have 26,000.
Yes.
When you first highlight this invoice and go to discount and credit,
okay,
and in the credit,
in the credit, I have a different invoice number. It's 3990. So I don't understand where is the problem. In the credit, I have a different invoice number, 3990.
No, that is the credit number. When you are taking the credit, there is a number for that. That's the credit number.
Okay.
That is not the invoice number. Invoice number is here. You are selecting the invoice number already here. See?
Okay.
This is the invoice you selected. And when you go there, that is the credit number. When you apply the credit, that's the credit number.
Okay.
Then this is the total credit limit. You already paid 28,000. From the 28,000,
Sorry that I'm disrupting you, but I don't have in the credit line, I don't have that invoice showing.
Here it's not going to show. Here you can see that. See, this is the screen you can see. This is the date, this is the credit number, this is the credit amount. That credit amount you're going to use only 8,000 here. This is about credit. The invoice information are here.
Okay.
You are in the different screen. Your invoice screen is here. This one is about the credit screen. You can see how much you paid, the total credit, and you are taking only 8,000 from this. You are going to use only 8,000 amount to use, and then say done.
Matilda, can I interrupt for 1 second?
Yeah.
Would it be faster, like if she just screen shared, so you can see what's on her screen?
Yeah, and normally I'm doing that, yes. Okay.
It's like if Valentina screen shares, like we can talk like what she's talking about, right?
Do you want to share the screen, Valentina?
Yes. Give me a moment, sure.
Hello?
Do you see it now?
Yeah.
Hello?
Yeah, so you see that I have a customer payment and I have these two invoices, 208 and 210.
Okay, Valentina. See, this is the invoice you are going to apply.
Okay.
Then highlight this invoice and go to discount and credit.
Jesus Christ.
Hello?
I let him in to put a check mark?
No. Don't put the check mark. When you put the check mark, the amount will come automatically here. That means when you receive the money, you have to put the tick mark. Okay, now go to discount and credit.
Hello?
Yes.
This is Muhammad. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay, so unfortunately, I don't have the email about the QuickBook before 12, January 12th. And I'm totally losing all the information about the session. Today I figure out that at 9:15 that we have a session, and before I tried to download the QuickBook, I didn't have it. So sorry, I'm totally lost, and I don't want to waste more time. I don't know what's going on. So who can assist me about the QuickBook, because I'm totally lost right now. I don't know what's happening. The email was in delay. The today session, even I received it from 15 minutes before the session started, and I don't know what's happening.
Are you Muhammad Khan?
Muhammad Abdurrahman, not Khan.
Did you come for the last classes?
I didn't have the email in Jan 12. I received the email Jan 13 while I was at work.
Actually, we finished two classes last time. Okay. We are going to start a new class in February 1st. Are you going to join with that?
Pardon me?
Are you going to join with the next batch? Next batch
okay,
is ready.
But yes, but unfortunately, the email that I received from Elizabeth, not from Matilda, I think.
Actually, I didn't have your email address, I think.
Okay, I can send to you right now, and you can give me the information that I should.
Yes, I can give the information, but okay. Not now, because we already started, we finished three classes.
No, I'm just asking about the next one. It's after 2 weeks, as you said.
Yeah, next batch, yes.
So I will send you a message right now with my email, my numbers, because all the what I received, it was in delay. I received it in Jan 13th after the first class already finished. And also the download of the application was not successfully done. So I think November, February, it will be better for me.
Yes, I will send all the information after the class. And also, if you want, I can show how to do that.
Yes, please. I will appreciate it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Then
so
you can join the February class, okay?
Okay, I will send because you all.
Today, this class, I have almost 14 people.
Yeah.
And next class, we are going to have another batch. At the time, you can join. Okay, I'm going to send all the information.
Yes, okay.
Okay.
The only thing is that I'm working overnight 12 hours from 5 to 5. So usually, if the class is at the morning, like before 12, it will be hard to join.
Okay, we can talk about that by email.
Okay.
Mohammed, I'm going to send the email to you, then we can discuss about that.
Thank
okay?
You
yeah.
You.
You're welcome. Okay. Valentina? Valentina?
Yes, I'm here. Go.
Hello, Valentina.
Yes, yes, I'm listening. Sorry, Matilda.
Take off this amount, 16948. Delete that amount, type 8,000.
8,000.
Yeah. You applied 8,000 for this particular invoice, and okay, you have 28,000 prepayment. And now, after you apply, go to discount and delete the discount amount. Take it off. No discount for this. Say done.
Should click, I sell
click
discount?
On done. No discount.
Okay.
No discount. If you don't apply the discount, you don't have to select the account number. Okay, done. Then go back to the second invoice the same way. Only highlight. And again, go to discount. See, the system automatically take the balance. And go to discount and take off the discount and say done. And now you can save and close.
It matches now? Yeah, zero. Available credit,
yeah.
Zero.
Yeah.
Thank you very much for your help, Matilda. Thank you.
Do you know what did you do? You already got the prepayment earlier as unearned income. Now you're applying that unearned income for the invoices. Right? Then now you can stop sharing. I can share mine.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Okay, after that, save and close. Next one is the next page. Not the next page, sorry. Page 344. Page 344 on the top, page D2.
Memo 2.
Yeah.
Dated October 1st, 2005. Applied the $9,000 deposit from Woodbridge Hills Academy of Art to the balance owing on invoice 199.
This one also the same as like the previous invoice, previous transaction. You are going to apply 9,000 deposit for Foothills Academy of Art, the balance owing on invoice 199. Now you are going to click which icon?
Receipt payment.
Receipt payment, very good. When you click on receipt payment, you can see the balance. Select the customer. Change the date. Oops. And you can see the balance in the bottom. $9,000 you have. You are going to apply that $9,000. In this case, highlight, don't put the tick mark, and discount and credit. The system automatically take the balance because there is only one invoice. Now you can say done.
So credit 02?
Yeah.
Matilda, do you not need to change the discount amount to 0?
Yeah, change. There is no
it's
discount.
All, yeah,
next one.
Matilda, I just have a question. How do I know that when we read the introduction about this company, it said how a customer comes to have the credit balance. I'm trying to look for it to find the explanation. Could you just explain to me again, how does a customer, like, for example, previous customer, how do they have a $9,000 credit balance?
That one is they paid earlier, in September.
It was a prepayment?
It was in the history, yeah. It was in the history.
Oh, okay. And right now we just applied another prepayment?
Yeah.
Are they paying for their invoice and installments or something?
invoice, they will pay later. Now we apply. According to this, we got the advance earlier in September. Now, October 1st, we are sending the invoice for them. When we are sending the invoice, we are applying that credit.
Oh, I see. Basically, we never credited them for their $9,000 payment previously.
No.
And now we're just crediting them on their invoice
for
their $9,000 payment. Yeah. I totally understand now. Thank you.
Yes. Next one is page, the same page, SD3, cash receipt.
Cash receipt number 335, dated October 2nd, 2012, from Athabasca Almonte Association, sheet number 40384. 29.083 dollars and not just component of the account, including the discount for early payment. The difference was 308 and 210.
Mm-hmm. You understand what is this transaction, right? When you are sending the invoice, they are sending the balance. They applied already credit. Now we are going to apply the check for that Athabasca Alumni Association.
Record deposit?
No, receipt payment. We are receiving the money now, the balance. You sent the invoice earlier for the Athabasca and you had credit already, you applied. Now you are receiving the balance. See, this is the original invoice total. After you apply the credit, this is the balance. Amount due, this is 9,120, 20,520 for the second invoice. They are applying for these two invoices. First of all, put the amount. How much you receive? Change the date. Date is... October 2nd.
And what is the amount?
October 2nd. And first, okay, don't put the amount first. Don't put the amount first. Go to discount. No, highlight the first invoice. Highlight the first invoice and calculate the discount first. Go to discount. And the first invoice discount is 171.20 for the balance.
Mm-hmm.
And now you are going to select the discount account. That's a sales discount. And done. Then go back to the second one, calculate the discount again for the second one.
Which kind of discount did we select?
Say again?
Which kind of discount did we select in the discount account?
A sales discount.
Sales discount.
Yeah. See, now the discount we already calculated. Now put the amount. And the check number, when you go to, the check number is 4038. See, now you can see. Applied, how much discount is, how much everything is in the bottom.
How did you know that the percentage of a discount is that much?
Pardon me, I don't...
We didn't select the amount of discount, right? It was automatically came, right?
Based on the date. When you put the date, okay, the system will recognize, because when you are setting up the customer's information, we are giving the terms. Based on the term, the system is recognizing the customer has discount. If you change the date for after due date, you can't calculate, the system won't calculate the discount.
Okay, before we put the information, we put the information about this customer, and we put the net, like, we put it the amount of the percentage of discount, right?
Yeah, 2%, 2/10, 1/10. Those mm-hmm. are the discount.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
I think this is 1% discount. See, they're taking the 1% discount. Now you can save and close.
Make sure the intro said customers who have accounts with them. So basically the regular customers, they get 1% of what they pay within 10 days. So yeah, 1%.
Yeah.
That was the intro on page 332.
Okay, now you can save and close. After you finish, you can save and close. Next one is in page 349.
Check copy number 418. Dated October 2nd, 2010. To travel.
Could you read about the purchase discount?
Okay, entering purchase account discounts. The next transaction that we need to enter is a check to travel tax payment of account. The payment is made before the early period discount date. So it includes a discount. So we have discount in this. Refer to the following source documents as we walk through the steps to enter it. SD number 4, check copy number 418. The travel totals 1,126.86 in payment of account, including 2% discount for early payment. Reference invoice TT 5001.
You already learned about the sales credit and discount. Now you are going to apply purchase. If you want to apply for the purchase, same as like receipt payment, here you are paying bills, right?
Mm-hmm.
Go to pay bills.
It's in vendors, right?
Yeah, under vendors, you have payables.
Okay.
In the payables, which vendor? Travel Tours. See, this is the invoice you are going to pay with a discount. Right?
Yes.
Then you have to put the tick mark. See, in the bottom, you can see set discount, set credits. You can see that in the bottom, right? That one is gray, it's not active. When you put the tick mark, it will get active. Now you are going to click on set discount. Check the date. This is the date you have to change it. The date is October 2nd, right? Now you are going to set discount.
October 2nd.
When you go to set discount, you can see the discount amount here, 25.04. Right? And also the account also is coming, which is discount.
And the amount is done 25.04, right?
Yeah. That one is, the system is calculating according to date. And also it says 2%, right? 2% if you pay before 5 days.
Yes. And yeah. Is it correct? Because I have the date automatically. So in the bottom set discount and the date October 2nd. But when the window discount and credits opened, I have a date October 3rd. Is it correct? Discount date October 3rd.
Yeah, for me also the same date.
October 3rd, right?
Yeah, yes. It's showing as discount date October 3rd.
Yes.
But here I selected. I don't know why it is showing that. Yeah, maybe within 5 days.
Before the payment.
And also, I have no idea why it is changing, but this is the date we are giving. And the amount is calculating automatically. And after that, you can say done.
Okay.
Now the discount is applied already here.
Mm-hmm.
And this is the total amount, but now we are paying only this amount.
1, 2, 26, 36.
Mm-hmm. Pay selected bill. Done.
Yeah.
I think yeah. The reason it was giving October 3rd was it's like a different discount date, right? Because I think like one is 2%, 5 net 30. And then yeah. After that, it's like 1%, 1 net 30, right? So because of that, I think October 3rd is the due date for the 2% discount. And mm-hmm. Then I think that's why the discount date is October 3rd. I think it's...
Okay. The due date.
Yeah.
The date is due. Okay.
Yeah,
but we are paying on
2%, 1%.
Okay, thank you, Mohamed. The due date is showing, Valentina.
Oh, okay, Matilda. And now after this, I have to select pay selected bills, right?
Yeah.
Okay, and pay more bills or done?
Done. Because you are paying only one invoice according to this transaction.
Oh, okay, Matilda. Now I have to leave you. I have to start my work.
Oh, you're going to work. Okay, yes. Try at home. Yeah, try at home. If you have any questions, you can send an email.
Thank you very much, Matilda. I really, really appreciate it. All the best to you guys. Have a nice day. Bye.
Go back to page 352 after you finish.
Paying a second bill. We will pay the telephone bill from Hotels Communications at the same time. So you need to include it in this payment entry. Refer to the following source document as we work through the steps to enter it. SD check copy 488 to Hotels Communication. $128.40 in full payment of account. Reference invoice FC10982.
Okay. This is, you are paying, right? Paying the second bill.
Yes.
You have to go to the same place.
Yes. And select the details.
Food is communication. There is no discount, you are paying the same amount.
And the payment.
And let's check number. They selected those. And the date also you have to pay attention. Oh, October 2nd, that's fine. Go back to selected those. And done. After you finish page 354, the bottom, entering purchase orders.
Entering purchase orders. Purchase orders are used to request items from vendors for later delivery. For internal control, some businesses require authorized purchase orders for all purchases that exceed a certain dollar amount. In the next transaction, you will enter a purchase order for travel checks. Refer to the following source document as we walk through the steps to enter. This means the purchase order. Dated October 7, 2000, the travel cost was $900 plus GST for 100 tote bags and passport wallet printed with the company logo. Purchase order totals $945. A deposit of 50% is requested to confirm the order. We will enter the purchase order now and enter the deposit a little later in the chapter.
Okay. Under vendors, this time you can see more icons, right? Purchase there are order. Purchase orders, receive inventory, enter bills.
Yes.
Now you are going to select purchase order. Purchase order is not a transaction, it's not going to GL, but it's a temporary temporary transaction. Temporary information you are going to put in the purchase order. Click on purchase order. When you click on purchase order, also you can see same as like enter bills. Select the customer. Travel tote. And now the date is October 2nd. And purchase order number is 30. And come back to the item. The item is travel vouchers. Yeah, travel accessories. And the amount is $900. Press tab button. And the total is
$945.
If you have any, if you want to write anything, you can write down the message. You can write down anything about the deposit, 50% or whatever.
Matilda?
Yeah?
Shouldn't you put in the quantity there?
No, no quantity.
There's no quantity? Okay.
Because this one is, there is no quantity, right?
No, there is.
In the transaction, they are saying travel tote.
There is. It says 100 tote bags.
Okay, then you can put the quantities if you want. It's not. And if you put the quantity, then this one should be when you put the line in there. Okay.
Did you put the quantity?
Yeah. If you want, but it's not necessary. Anyway, yeah, put the quantity. Now you can see how much is the total. Now you can save and close. Next one is after you finish, go to page 358.
Catering source states. Companies that provide service frequently give customers cost estimates for the service requested. Customers then can decide whether to get other estimates or to continue with the purchase. Sometimes estimates are required. For example, a car insurance company may request one or more estimates for automobile repairs before they will cover the repair costs. Medical insurance also often asks for written estimates from doctors before procedures are completed and payment is approved. Cherry Pick Tours provides estimates on request for any group interested in traveling with them. In the next transaction, you will enter a sales estimate, the Upper Crest School for Boys. SD student, sales estimate 21, dated October 2nd, 2012, to Upper Crest School for Boys, $16,020 plus.
Can I interrupt you for 1 second? Matilda, can you let Elizabeth in the chat room?
I
am in, thank you. I am in.
Yeah. I already did the moment, yeah. Okay.
Plus GST for airfare and $28,800 for tower component of complete tower package.
21.
7.
Sorry, 7. 7. My bad. 7.
Page 358.
Could you up your volume, Bina?
Yes.
Yeah.
A complete tower package for 18 senior students and adults. The price of the 9-day tower includes airfare and accommodation and will cover major galleries and museums in European capital cities. Total cost of tower including taxes is $45,821.
Okay. this one is sales estimate. You understand what is sales estimate, right? The customer is asking for the quotation. That is the sales estimate. Under customers, you can see the sales estimate. The previous company, you don't have these icons. Now you have so many icons. This is the sales estimate. Click on sales estimate. Select the customer from here. Upper Crest School, and date is October 2nd, and go back to item, airfare, The amount is 16020. Press tab button. The second one is two components. That one is total amount is 28,800. And the estimate number is 21. Are you okay?
Matilda, I do have a question. Mm-hmm. So this was just a quote we gave to this customer. Suppose they, notify us the next day and say, okay, we're interested in going through with this transaction. Mm-hmm. Do we have to come back to estimates, and is there a way to switch it to an invoice, or do we have to input all this information on you?
We have to switch it to invoice.
Oh, okay. How do we do that? Or are we going to learn that later?
That one is going to do it, yeah.
Okay.
Because now we are recording and sending the quotation. If they accept the quotation, you are going to transfer the invoice.
Okay.
When you click the invoice, the system will ask you, you have the estimate, do you want to accept?
Oh.
You can accept, yeah.
Cool.
Different software, different way. They'll say Sage 50. In the estimate, we can change for the invoice in the same place. But this one, we have to go to invoice. And the invoice, you will get a message. You have an estimate, do you want to accept? Then you have to accept.
Okay.
After finish, you can save and close. You will have the message because when we set up the company, we get the tax code as G, but some of the item doesn't have HST. That's what they asked in the question. Any message before you close, you have to read. Next one is page 164. That is sales order.
Comparing sales orders. Sales orders differ from estimates in that they originate with the customer. Frequently, after a company provides an estimate, the customer will place an order for the items or service in the estimate. Estimates precede the decision to buy and often influence the decision to buy. Sales orders come after the customer has decided to proceed with the purchase. Cherry Pictures prepares sales orders when customers place a firm order. In the next transaction, we have SD8, sales order, number 6, dated October 2. to Calgary District School Board, $16,280 plus GST for the airfare and $28,380 for the tour to create the complete tour package for 20 students and two teachers. Price of the 8-day history of England Tower includes airfare and accommodation. Total cost of the tower including taxes is $45,474.
Mm-hmm.
You are going to create invoice?
No. Sales order. Sales order is not an invoice. See, estimate. This is also sales order. You are receiving the order from the customer. Mm-hmm. Click on sales order. The previous transaction is sales estimate. This one is sales order. You are sending the estimate. This is the sales order. Calgary District School. Airfare items. Make sure everything is correct, then you can save and close.
Matilda, what's the difference between sales order and create invoice?
Sales order, you are receiving the order. After that, you are going to create the invoice.
Why is it not just one step? Why is it not just create invoice? Can we just do create invoice and skip sales order?
Actually, yeah, according to the order, you are going to create the invoice. The customer has the need order.
Okay, I see. I understand now. The sales order is where you input the information, and then the invoice will pre-populate this information. I understand now. I get it.
Sales order, you are recording the sales order. Because
you're recording the details, what exactly you're selling, and the invoice will,
According to this exercise, they are teaching how to record the sales orders, how to record the invoice. But in the real life, you are not going to record the sales order directly, you can go. But, you know, like some of the companies, they are keeping the sales order in the file. That's what they are recording.
Right. Okay. So suppose this was, a customer that walked in, not like an account customer, and, you know, paid it on the spot immediately. You would do a sales order and then a receipt. You wouldn't need an invoice, right?
No. Yeah.
Okay.
That one is cash. Immediately when they pay, that one is the cash transaction. This one is credit
transaction. Okay. Right, no. But even so, if the cash transaction, do we just go straight to receive payments?
Yeah, straight with a different icon. You are going to use a different icon, but
which is
no sales, immediately you are paying, yeah.
I know. Yeah. I'm saying, suppose in a different situation, a different scenario, the customer pays immediately, okay, they're not an account customer, they're an irregular customer, and they pay on the spot as soon as they walk into your business or whatever they call you, they pay in full. Which icon would you then select? Is it receive payments?
No.
Which one would you select? Sales order?
See this one. this one, create sales receipt.
Oh, okay, thank you.
Yesterday you did this one, right, with the cash sales? The same icon you have to use for the cash transaction. Cash debit, sales credit.
Okay.
Sales order, after you finish the sales order, you can save and close. Now you can go to 368.
Entering customer prepayments.
Yeah. This is the one they already recorded for Athabasca Alumni Association earlier. That is the transaction you are going to do it now. How, somebody was asking about how they have 28,000 in the system, right? That one you are going to do it now. The same kind of transaction you are going to do it now.
Customer prepayments or deposits are entered just like other customer payments because you are receiving a check from a customer. The difference is that when you enter a customer payment or deposit, no invoice is selected for payment. Prepayments are entered on the received payments form. And in the next transaction, we will enter a customer prepayment for from upper class school board for boys. For estimate number 21, refer to the following source document as we work through the steps to enter it. SD9, cash receipt, dated October 3rd. From upper class school for boys, check number 198 for $25,000 as prepayment to accept estimate 20, number 21 and confirm the job.
You already sent the estimate for this customer. Now they are asking 50% prepayment. That's what they are receiving, that money. Right? Yes. Go back to receipt payment. Because you are, when you are receiving money, you have to go to receipt payment. And select the customer. And when you select the customer, you have some outstanding balances. Don't worry about the outstanding balances. They are paying for different estimate. Now you are going to put the amount 25,000. And the date is October 3rd. And check number is
98.
Cash receipt 346. Maybe I can put 346. And see, the system automatically apply for 3,000. Take off the tick mark.
But because the check number is 6985 3406. This is cash receipt number.
Oh, 6 9 8. Okay. Don't apply for the invoice because this is for something else. And the memo you can write down for estimate 21. This is the way when they are getting the prepayment. Actually, this one is cash debit, unearned revenue credit. Then we are doing the manual accounting, right? But in the system, they pre-programmed like this. We have to apply in the customer's file. This one is going to be the customer's file. Then we can apply for the invoice later on.
Can you just repeat that? questions.
Now you can. Pardon me?
Can you just repeat that? What did you say about that?
I can't hear you. What?
I just want to say that. Can you please repeat the words that you said about the credit under the site? Can you hear me?
No, I couldn't.
Sorry.
Because I can hear you, but I couldn't understand what the word you.
Yeah, you mentioned that in the manual account we have debit and credit.
Yeah.
Can you just repeat that?
Okay. In the manual accounting, when we get a prepayment, we are recording as bank debit, unearned revenue credit, right?
Mm-hmm.
That is the transaction we are doing now. But we are not doing in the unearned revenue. It's automatically go to customer's file as a prepayment.
Okay.
When we record the invoice, then the system will automatically take the prepayment when we are recording the invoice. If we don't want to do it at the same time, we can leave it as a prepayment and apply later.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay. Sorry, Bina, sometimes...
Yeah, sorry, my voice is not...
Your voice is very soft. Okay. Everybody understand how to record the prepayment? When you're applying the prepayment, don't apply for the invoices. That one, next time when you open this, you can see the prepayment in the bottom. Save and close. If you want to print the credit memo to send the customers, you can print from here. If you go to receive payment and select the customer upper crust, now you can see this is the prepayment. Mafisa?
Yes, I have a question. The prepayment amount, is it up to the customer, or is it at least 50%? Because in this case, they paid 90% roughly, right? The total.
50%. They're asking for 50% according to their rules, right?
But the customer chose to pay more.
Yeah.
Okay.
Now you understand how the prepayment came for the system, right? Okay. Next one. Next one is SD10, that one is pay 370.
From Calgary District School Board, check number 3902 for $22,000 as prepayment to confirm sales order number 6.
Yeah, sales order. Last time we paid for the estimate, this time they are paying for, this company is paying for the sales order. Okay. Go to receive payment, same as like that.
Matilda, I have one question about prepayment. Prepayment means we receive payment in advance from the customer.
Yeah.
And we will provide him product or services later on.
Yeah.
But we have received money in advance. So, yeah. When you were teaching us, entry like we receive money, it means debit our bank and credit unearned revenue, right?
Yeah.
So now in this case in QuickBooks we are making hitting direct to receive payments customer account.
Yeah.
So
it
is becoming confusing for me. Where is becoming that entries which we make in general journal entries like debit bank and credit unearned revenue, because we are in this case we are hitting direct receive payment to the customer prepay payment. So
according to the software, they pre-programmed according to that, easy to apply for customer directly later on. The software pre-programmed according to this way, because when we applied in the customer's file as a prepayment, that one is going to be in the credit side.
Okay.
Customer bank is going to be debit. Customers, that is also unknown revenue. That one, the name is going to be prepayment. In this software, it's going to be in the credit side, the customer's file.
Okay.
When we create the invoice, it's automatically we can apply for that. The system will automatically apply for that.
Okay.
If we don't apply automatically, then we can apply later on. But you learn how to apply later.
Okay.
I think some of the transaction you will apply immediately, then you will understand.
Okay.
But when we are doing the manual accounting, we are showing as a unearned revenue, then we are transferring to customer file.
Okay.
But
Thank you. Here,
the software is programmed already to apply immediately for the customers as a credit balance.
Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you.
You're welcome. Next one is check copy SD11.
SD11, yes. To travel towards $500 as repayment to confirm purchase order number 30.
Okay. Remember, you have a purchase order for travel towards earlier. Now you are going to pay advance. When you are paying advance, you are printing the check and send it to vendor, right? If you want to pay advance, you have to print the check and send it to the vendor, right? In that case, if you want to pay the prepayment, not in payables, you have to go to write checks. Write checks, you can pay immediately. Cash payment. Click on write checks. Are you okay?
Yes.
And select the vendor. Travel towards. And when you're selecting the vendor, you will have a message. do you want to apply the purchase order? Open the purchase order if it's to come out. Do you want to receive? Say no, because we are not going to use the purchase order now. We are going to pay only advance. Say no. Now, there's an expenses and the items. You are going to select the expenses. The transaction is going to be, bank is going to be credit. Vendor's account is going to be debit. Vendor's accounts payable account is going to be debit. In that case, we are going to select accounts payable. And the amount is going to be $500. You can write the memo, prepayment for purchase order number 30. Hello, Sophia? Yeah. Yeah. Payroll time. Yes. Both. Today is the payroll. Yeah. Yeah. Payroll hours. Yeah. Yeah. And also you have teaching hours also, right? Everything together, okay. No, put the hours, then I will do the other calculation. Okay, you're welcome. Bye, Sophia. Okay. The date and also the amount and the... You're selecting the accounts payable. This one is going to be in the accounts payable in the debit side. When you prepare the invoice, you can apply easily for the vendor. This is normally in the real life. Prepayment is our asset account. Remember, cash is going to be credit. Prepayment is going to be debit. The same thing in accounts payable is going to be in the debit side. Bank is going to be credit. Save and close. Do you understand? When you are paying the prepayment, you have to go to write checks and select the accounts payable for the particular vendor. And in the particular vendor's ledger, it's going to be in the credit and debit side. Save and close. Next one is 372. There are some transactions. 372, there are three transactions.
Yes, teacher, check copy 483 and 484, dated October 5th, to Paris Printing House, check 483 for $933.25 in payment of account, including the discount for early payment, reference invoice PPH 1800. To Heritage Hotels, check 484 for $13,770.90 in payment of account, including the discount for early payment, reference invoice HH12-2099.
You are going to pay for two vendors with a discount. Where to go? Payment for vendors. Pay bills, yes. Pay bills first, printing house. Select printing house and go to set discounts. And discounts and then send done. And go back to next one, Heritage Hotels. And set discount, that one also you already did. Now you are paying to two vendors. And pay selected bills. Next one is purchase invoice.
Purchase invoice. From Spotless Cleaners, set up new vendor. $180 plus GST for cleaning office. Purchase invoice total $189, terms 210, and net 30 days. Memorize the transaction with weekly reminders beginning October 12.
You have you have the information in the gray area. Now, which icon you are going to use it?
Wait, invoice.
This one is vendor's invoice. You are purchasing the service. Oh, yeah. Which icon?
Bills,
because you are purchasing the services from Spotless Cleaners.
Enter bills,
yeah. Enter bills, you don't have this vendor. Type the name and press tab.
Spotless Cleaners.
When you press the tab button, you can see quick get setup. Click on setup and give the information about the address from here. And address is here. You can put the address and after that come back to payment settings. You have $1,000 credit limit and also the term is 210 and 30.
change the date.
Account is maintenance and cleaning.
Sorry, excuse me. Matilda, did you on the set what is it called? On the setup of new vendor, did you put a credit limit?
Yeah. The payment setting. The payment setting, there's a tab.
Okay.
And the payment settings and the right corner there is credit limit.
Okay, because I didn't see it in the question, that's what I'm wondering. I didn't see it in the question where it states the limits, that the customer has a limit. So why are we putting a limit?
It is the gray area.
Can I have
a limit?
Okay, it's not visible. Okay, thank you. I'll note it in my own.
And also the terms also you have to select.
Yeah, I saw that. The limits, okay, I'll send it. Thank you.
You're welcome. Are you okay? And memorize this transaction after you fill. A weekly cleaning and the date is October 12th. Next one is also purchase the invoice.
From here is $12,600 plus GST for airfare for upper correct school for boys. Purchase invoice total $13,000 and 230 transmit
The company, they are buying these airfare tickets for the customer upper crest school, right? There's an option for the customer. If you purchase something for a particular customer, you can select the customer here also. Mm-hmm. Then you can see when you see the transaction, you can see to whom you purchased that transaction. Total is 10 and 7 costs.
Tilda?
Yeah.
Can I ask you a question? It's kind of unrelated to this, but it's like kind of related. So once you create the bill and you put in the customer's name there, right?
Mm-hmm.
Does the system automatically generate an invoice for the customer?
No. This is especially for the costing.
Okay.
Yeah. When you're purchasing that, this is for costing purpose.
Okay. So it doesn't generate the invoice. It doesn't apply like the credit that the customer made. Like it doesn't apply against it or anything like
No. Actually, for our purpose, accounting purpose, the system is not programmed like that way.
Okay.
There's a limit for QuickBooks, H50. Those things are limited access, something like that.
So we have to make like a debit entry ourselves or something like that.
Yeah. Did you work with a different software before? Mohammed? Are you computer person?
Sorry?
You are an IT?
No. Just because it's just like a question, right? Like, yeah.
Okay. Because yesterday you told me about the, I have to say, save it in Google Drive and send it to, if it is big, I did that way yesterday, this data, the book.
Yeah.
That's what I was thinking, he's an IT or something. I save it in Google Drive and send the link to that book. Next one is purchase invoice again.
Yes. From Heritage Hotels, $16,300, including all local passes for double hotel accommodation for 18 adults for 8 nights. No Canadian taxes apply because the hotels are not in Canada. Tax extent is the tax code. Terms 1/10 net flexible.
Tilda, did we put the terms and this in the transaction?
No, terms already there.
Ah, okay, terms already there. Okay, fine.
Go and see the transaction, see? This is the terms. When you set up vendors or customers, you are selecting the terms also with the data. Then when you prepare the invoice, it comes automatically.
Okay, thank you.
This is the terms. You're welcome. After you finish, next one.
Received items shipment. Here purchase order number 30 from Travel Tote. Received 100 tote bags and wallets for $900 plus $45 GST. Invoice total.
Could you read the receiving items from the purchase order?
Okay, yes.
Could you please say a little bit louder?
Okay. When you receive merchandise that has been entered on a purchase order, you must fill the order. Items may be shipped with the invoice, or the invoice may be mailed separately. In this example, the items are before the invoice, so we will enter the received items first. In the next transaction, we will receive items from purchase order number 30 from Travel Tots. Received items shipment. Still purchase order 30 from Travel Tots. Received 100 tote bags and wallet for $900 plus 45 GST. Invoice totals $945. All items were received and the bill will follow terms 2/5 meant 30 days.
You already sent the purchase order earlier for this vendor. Now you are receiving the items without bill. Right? You understand this transaction, right?
Yes.
Remember you sent the purchase order earlier for Travel Totes, 400 tote bags. Now they are sending the items, but invoice is not coming now. Then, see, after the purchase order, you can see the part. This is the receive inventory. This is the new one, not in the Marlins. This is the inventory item. That one is the service company. This is inventory company. When you are receiving inventory, you have to click this button and you will see two options. One is receive inventory with bill, other one is receive inventory without bill. This time we haven't received the invoice, that's what we have to select without bill. And select the customer, vendor. When you select the vendor, the system it's asking about the purchase order. Open the purchase order. The vendor, do you want to receive or, okay. Then you can say yes. Then you can access the purchase order. The purchase order is going to be in the screen. Say yes. This is the purchase order. And highlight the purchase order and say okay. Because sometimes when you open purchase order, you are going to have 2-3 purchase orders. Which purchase order you are going to select according to that, highlight and say okay. Now we have the information here. Right? Okay. Now, check the date and check the number. And check everything. And when you, after you finish everything, when you save, 7 clause. When you save and close, you have a message, right? What is the message? Is
like a different type of account for this one.
Pardon me?
It says select a different type of account for this one. You can always select an account payable or accounts receivable.
You understand what it is saying? Because we select the items. And at the same time, the system has a memory for travel tolls. Earlier, we paid advance. When we paid advance, we selected accounts payable. That one is going to be in the memory. That one is showing here. We can't use items and accounts at the same time. That's what the message is. Take off the accounts payable. And now go back to items. Now save and close. It will save automatically.
What to select accounts?
Accounts payable, because we use this vendor for the prepayment. When we use this vendor for the prepayment, we selected accounts payable. That number was in the memory. That's what when we are applying the items, the system won't allow you to do both. Then take off accounts payable and continue with the item. After you finish, the next one is 375.
Entering a bill for received items. When a bill arrives for items that have already been received and entered on the create item receipt form, it's entered by selecting the enter bills against inventory icon in the vendor section of the homepage. In the next transaction, you will receive a purchase invoice from Travel Plus for shipment 45590. Refer to the following source document as we work through the steps to enter it. Receive purchase invoice. Receive a bill from Travel Plus for $900 plus 45 GST dollars, invoice totals $945, terms 2/5, net 30 days.
Okay. the first step was purchase order. The second step was when we receive the inventory. Now we are receiving the invoice. Then we have to go to enter bills against the inventory. After you finish this transaction, it's going to be the ledger. Click on enter bills against and select the vendor. When you select the vendor, you can see the information. Highlight and say OK. Now you have the invoice. Make sure everything is okay. Now you can. Save it. Next one is page 377.
SD18. Supplies printing house, $1,400 plus GST for printing new travel brochures to give to clients. Purchase order totals $1,470. A 25% deposit is requested to confirm order.
This one is purchase order. Party printing house.
Sorry, Matilda?
Yeah.
Okay. So the 25% deposit, we do that on that payment or how?
No, now this is the message. You can write down in the message. Because you are not paying now.
Okay.
That is the information. When you are sending the purchase order, that is the information. You can put in the message, but the payment will come in the next transactions.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Next one is page 378, SD19.
Cash sales received summary from individual cash sales customers, $4,200 plus GST for flights and $3,100 for tours during the week. Sales invoice total of $7,510 was paid by Visa. Visa credit card receipts are deposits to bank Visa account. Memorize the transaction with weekly reminders beginning October 14th.
Actually, this is the cashier because they are paying immediately by credit cards. You are receiving money, cash is debit, the sales is credit. In that case, you have to select create sales receipt. This is cashiers. Cashier customers item flights 4,200. This is total.
The first amount is just $4,200.
I put 10 more, okay. Okay, and payment method, you have to select the payment method and select Visa. This one is going to Visa account, bank Visa account. And you are going to memorize these transactions. Page 3 is 380.
Creating invoices from estimates or SD20.
SD20.
To appear upper crest school for boys. Based on estimate number 21, $16,020 plus 50% GST for the A fare and $28,800 for the tower component in the European capital city's tower. Total cost of the tower including taxes is 45,621 dollars. Terms 1+10 net 30.
This one is, you are going to create an invoice from the estimate sales invoice. Go to create invoice and select the customer upper crust cover. Then you will have a message that you have a estimate. Then highlight the estimate and say okay. Then you can convert it to. Convert it to invoice. I think Mafisa, you asked me about last time, right? About the estimate when we are going to transfer the invoice, right?
Right, okay.
Yeah. The estimate is temporary information, but this is the invoice is going to the ledger now. Customer ledger and our account receivable ledger everywhere.
Okay.
And the date is going to be October 9. And invoice number is going to be 212. Check all the total whether it is right or wrong. Then you can save and close. See, the customer has credit limit if you do you want to apply. In the real life, you can apply immediately. But here, they are giving different transactions. That's what you don't have to apply. this exercise is teaching every options. That's what. Leave it. Now, page 383.
SD21. To Paris printing house. $375 as repayment to confirm purchase order 13.
Mm-hmm.
Repayment.
This is the prepayment. Where to go for the prepayment? When you are paying for the vendor?
Pay bills.
We are going to, no, this is the prepayment. Pay bills means if you have an invoice outstanding, you are paying. The pay bills, after you create the invoice, record your source document, then you are paying, that is the pay bills. This is the prepayment. You don't have any invoice, but your purchase order or something like that, you are paying now. When you are paying, you have to pay immediately, right? Cash is going to be credit?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. In that case, which one you are going to use? Choose? Mm-hmm. Write checks, because you are going to print the checks and give it to them.
Mm-hmm.
Click on write checks. Select the vendor party printing house, and the system is going to ask about the purchase order. Say no, because you are going to record later. And now the accounts, which accounts you are going to choose it.
Accounts payable?
Yeah, good. Good.
Matilda,
yeah.
The question says, like, as prepayment to confirm purchase order 31. So shouldn't you just apply against the purchase order?
Actually, they have an option later on.
Okay.
Because this is, you are going to confirm purchase order. That's what they are saying. But you are going to have another transaction to create the invoice. Actually, in the real life, you can accept. In the real life, you can accept, because that is not the exercises. But here they are giving the other transaction to create the invoice.
Okay.
Yeah.
Sorry, I have a question. So this one is what? If it's not for purchase order number 31, it is what actually?
The prepayment, because when you are sending the purchase order, the vendor is asking for 50% advance. You have to pay advance if they want to give the items or whatever, the purchase. You send the purchase order earlier for the party printing house, for the brochures or something like that. At the time, they're asking for the advance, right? That advance you are paying now.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah.
Can I leave the meeting, because I have another meeting that's already
okay later. almost is finishing. Yeah, you can leave it.
Thank you.
Hi at home, huh?
Okay.
The rest you can do it by yourself. It's easy. Okay. Do you want to do the next one? SD22, Mafisa?
Yeah, sure. So, purchase invoice number C25997 from Capital Tours, $8,400 for special local tours arranged for Athabasca Alumni Association. Mm-hmm. Terms 1 over 10, net 30 days.
Mm-hmm. This is very
paid invoice?
Interbills. This is purchase invoice, right? You are purchasing this, right? This one is purchase invoice going to Interbells. Sales invoice is create invoice. This is purchase invoice.
Are we doing SD22? Athabasca alumni is our customers, aren't they? Oh, but it's a purchase. We're buying something from them today?
SD22. You finished SD21. Now you are doing SD22, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. From Capital Tour?
Oh, from Capital Tours.
Yeah.
Right. Okay, I saw Alumni Association. Yeah, Athabasca, Athabasca Alumni is our customers, but Capital Tours is our vendor. Okay, there we go. So
they're purchasing from them for this customer.
Okay, right.
So are we going to enter invoice?
Pardon me?
Enter bills?
Yes, enter bills. Yeah, I was confused as to why it said purchase invoice and then it said Athabasca. Well, okay, so I missed
Athabasca Capital. Athabasca is our customer.
Right, and Athabasca is, Capital Tours is our vendor.
Yeah. Then
I thought we were the tour guides in this business. Like, you know, Terrific Tours, us, you know, the husband, wife, and sons.
Yeah.
I thought they were the tour guides. We're paying another company, Capital Tours, as well?
Yeah.
Okay.
You consider yourself like a travel agency, right? Just to meet somebody.
Yeah. I know. They're like a complete, the introduction said that, you know, sometimes their sons would be, I guess they weren't the tour guide. I guess they were just accompanying them to take care of their expenses.
Yesterday,
I mean, they have another daughter, Arinda, at the same period.
Right. Yeah. And actually, yeah, it mentioned that, yeah, they pay other services like museums and maybe it mentioned other tour companies too. Okay, it's understandable. So Capital Tours.
$8,400, right?
Right, yes, or 8,400.
And customer, you can select at the bus car.
Matilda, you put in an extra zero.
Okay. And the invoice number is 99599 or something. Okay. After this transaction, I am going to finish class because I have another class. You can try at home the rest, and in the next class we are going to continue some of the transaction if you don't understand, and I'm going to send another data for the different company. If you can do it by yourself, you can do it at home. Any question, you can bring it. And then
okay, so the next class will be Monday, sorry.
I send a schedule. I send a schedule, right?
Yeah.
I have to check the schedule because I have classes all over every day.
Okay, okay, I will try to check. I will ask other people, okay, because it's not a little, it's a little bit confusing, the schedule, that's why.
Actually, I think the next class is on the 12th.
It's on Wednesday, 26th.
Wednesday,
1:30
to 4.
1:30.
Right, right, yeah. 12th is the past, right. Wednesday, the 20th,
that's right. 20th, we are going to have afternoon class.
Sir, Matilda, are you the one also taking the bookkeeping and Excel?
I'm not doing Excel. I'm doing only bookkeeping.
Only bookkeeping?
Bookkeeping, QuickBook, and Sage 50.
Okay, so when are we starting the bookkeeping?
Bookkeeping, I will find out how many people are in the bookkeeping. You didn't do the bookkeeping earlier?
No, we've only done...
We didn't do.
We haven't done bookkeeping.
Okay. Then I will send an email.
Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Because I had to check my schedule, and I will send an email.
Okay. Thanks.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Matilda. Have a great day.
Thank you. Bye, everyone.
Thank you, Matilda.
You're welcome. Are you okay with the software now? You understand the software, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.